हेलो, शुड आई स्टार्ट? एम आई ऑडिबल? क्लियर है? नमस्कार, पढ़ई तुम्हार द्वार इस कार्यक्रम अंतर्गत एसईआरटी रायपुर प्रदेश के विद्यार्थियों के लिए सतत ऑनलाइन कक्षाएं कर रहे हैं। आज हम अपनी ऑनलाइन कक्षाओं के 54वें दिवस पर हैं, अर्थात हमने 53 दिन कंप्लीट कर लिए हैं और यह हमारी 234वीं क्लास है। और इन 234 क्लास तक हमसे 1,19,000 से अधिक विद्यार्थी अब तक जुड़ चुके हैं। ये बहुत ही खुशी की बात है, सुख और आनंद का विषय है हमारे लिए, क्योंकि आपका जुड़ना ही हमारे प्रयत्नों को सार्थक, आपका जुड़ना ही हमारी एक तरह से स्ट्रेंथ है। और इस स्ट्रेंथ को बनाए रखिए। जब आप पूरे उत्साह के साथ हमारी ऑनलाइन कक्षाओं में सम्मिलित होते हैं, तो इससे हमें और अधिक और प्रभावी कक्षाएं करने की प्रेरणा मिलती है और यह संख्या बतलाती है कि यहाँ से जो भी कक्षाएं प्रस्तुत की जाती हैं, हमारे शिक्षक जो यहाँ से ऑनलाइन कक्षाओं के लिए प्रस्तुत होते हैं, वो निश्चित तौर पर पूरी तैयारी के साथ होते हैं। और यह बात हमारे विद्यार्थियों को भी बहुत प्रभावित करती है और लाभ भी पहुंचा रही है। इसी तरह ऑनलाइन कक्षाओं में जुड़ते रहिए, अपने साथियों को, अपने सहपाठियों को, अपने मित्रों को, उन्हें भी प्रेरित करें कि वे ऑनलाइन कक्षाओं में भाग लें, समय का अच्छा उपयोग करें। ये सारे प्रयत्न, ये सारी कोशिशें आपके लिए। आज चौथे क्रम पर हमारी जो कक्षा है वो है अंग्रेजी विषय के लिए, कक्षा 12वीं के लिए। और इसके लिए हमारे बीच उपस्थित हैं मैडम ऋजुता शर्मा। मैडम ऋजुता शर्मा इसके पहले भी कक्षाएं ले चुकी हैं, उनकी कक्षाएं बहुत अप्रिशिएट की जाती हैं स्टूडेंट्स के द्वारा, और मुझे लगता है कि अब अलग से परिचय देने की आवश्यकता नहीं है, क्योंकि शिक्षक का अध्यापन ही उसका परिचय बनता है। और विवेकानंद के लिए तो ये बन चुका है, बहुत जाना पहचाना चेहरा है अब हमारे विद्यार्थियों के लिए। बिना किसी विलंब के मैं आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट विवेका मैम टू स्टार्ट द सेशन। हेलो
स्टार्ट करूं? स्क्रीन शेयर मीन्स नहीं, ठीक है, हम बाद में भी हो सकता है, ऐसा कुछ नहीं, वो मैं भी क्वेश्चन भी पूछूं कुछ देर के बाद, ठीक है ना, ऐसा कुछ नहीं है। हाँ, अ वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन एंड अ वॉर्म वेलकम टू दिस क्लास। डीप वाटर, दिस इज द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर which we are going to cover today. Deep water, it has a very deep meaning. It means a serious trouble. It is the darkness of the life. It is the problem of the life. It represents the struggles of the life. When we say, I am in trouble, he is in trouble, she is in trouble, it means that they are in a very difficult situation. They are in a situation which is beyond their control. They can't handle it. We can't do anything. They are in a helpless situation. So today's chapter, what does this deep water mean? We will see. But before that, let's see a quick look अबाउट अवर राइटर विलियम डगलस. वेयर वी हैव टू या विलियम डगलस ही वॉज बॉर्न इन 1898 एंड डाइड इन 1980. ही वॉज बॉर्न इन मेन मिनेसोटा विच इज इन USA एंड ही वॉज अ फेमस अमेरिकन राइटर ज्यूरिस्ट एंड अ पॉलिटिशियन. ज्यूरिस्ट मीन एन एक्सपर्ट इन लॉ. हिज एजुकेशन ही ग्रेजुएटेड इन इंग्लिश एंड इकोनॉमिक्स. आफ्टर दैट ही टॉट इन हाई स्कूल इन याकिमा फॉर 2 years. याकिमा इज द नेम ऑफ अ सिटी इन वॉशिंगटन USA. A legal advisor and friend to the President Franklin D. Roosevelt. After that, he pursued his law. After 2 years teaching, he pursued his law in Columbia University, and then he became a legal advisor and a friend to the President Franklin D. Roosevelt. President Franklin D. Roosevelt is a very popular and famous president of America. His famous autobiography means Atmakatha of Man and Mountains. This chapter is an excerpt, or we can say an extract, from his autobiography of Man and Mountains. Excerpt and extract means ansh, a part of a something big. Let's move to the another slide. So students, I am Danish. Here a Danish Dhamani is a young man. He is sharing his inspirational story with you, and I hope you all, most of you, will identify his stories. You must have experienced the same experience as the Danish Dhamani experienced. मुझे विश्वास है कि जो Danish Dhamani ने जो अनुभव किया था, जिस सिचुएशन से वो गुजरे थे, आप उसकी स्टोरी से रिलेट कर पाएंगे. सो हियर दानिश धमानी स्पीकिंग टू यू. हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज दानिश धमानी. वन डे व्हेन आई वाज बिजी स्केचिंग माय ड्रीम कार्ड्स इन माय नोटबुक्स, ऑल ऑफ अ सडन आई हर्ड माय टीचर्स वॉइस. शी सेड, दानिश, कैन यू प्लीज राइज अप and introduce yourself. She put me in the spot. 30 pair of eyes were staring at me. My mind went blank. My heart started racing. I heard giggling in the class, and then the tears came down on my cheeks. So here Danish is sharing his experience. One day in a school, when he was sitting, suddenly his teacher asked him to introduce himself in front of the others. अचानक उसके टीचर ने क्लास में जब वो था सबके सामने अपना परिचय देने के लिए उसको बुलाया. So all of a sudden this thing was happened and he was not in a position to address the class. He was a shy. He had a fear of public speaking. So what happened at that time? His mind went blank. He was not able to think anything, and his heart started racing. Means his heart started beating fast, and he could hear some giggling sounds in the class. There were 30 students in the class. They started looking at him, and there was a sound of laughing. उन्हें हंसने की दबे स्वर में हंसने की कुछ आवाज सुनाई दी. Because he was not able to speak in front of the class. So no, previous one, second at college. No, higher. Then what happened? That was a experience when he was in school. Then after some years later, when Danish joined the school, that was my first time I felt the fear of public speaking. I felt fear speaking in front of the others. He had a fear speaking in the public. Few years later, when I was in college, the fear struck me again. I remember my first experience as a debater. I am still seized with fear and shame. Was to speak on India of my dreams. इंटर डिबेट कॉम्पिटिशन आई वॉन्टेड टू से सो मच बट कुडंट. नाउ अगेन ही शेयरिंग वेन ही वॉज इन हिस कॉलेज ही वॉज पार्टिसिपेटिंग इन अ डिबेट कॉम्पिटिशन बट ही वॉज अनेबल टू स्पीक एनीथिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ द पब्लिक एंड अगेन ही गॉट स्टक. फिर से जब वो कॉलेज में आए तो दोबारा से वो फिर से डिबेट कॉम्पिटिशन में ठीक से पार्टिसिपेट नहीं कर पाए, बोल नहीं पाए. नेक्स्ट, दानिश एफर्ट्स टू लर्न पब्लिक स्पीकिंग. एफर्ट्स, EFFORTS, efforts means koshish, prayatna. Learn public speaking. I fumbled for words. I felt the whole world laughing at me. FUMBLED, fumbled means he was short of the words. He couldn't speak any words. What did he feel at that time? He feel that the whole world, not only the class, not only the college, but the whole world is laughing at me. Sara sansar jaise mere pe hans raha hai. Because I was not able to speak anything. And then I decided to do something about it. I decided to take steps and find solution. And then what did Danish do? Usne ye nirnay kiya ki now enough is enough. I have to do something to overcome this fear. Ab bahut ho gaya hai. Ab mujhe jo dar lagta hai logon ke samne bolne mein, usko jeetne ka, uske jeetne ke liye mujhe kuch na kuch prayatn karna padega. So what did Danish do? I hired a speech coach and instructor, talked in front of the mirror, did online courses. उन्होंने क्या किया? He hired a speech coach. अपने लिए एक instructor, एक निरीक्षक instructor को उसने hire किया, coach को, और उसके training में उन्होंने started to take the training. And he started to talk in front of the mirror. जब वो कभी अकेले होते थे तो शीशे के सामने जाकर के वो बातें करते थे. एंड वो कहते थे कि शीशा जो था वो मेरा सबसे अच्छा दोस्त था जो कि मेरी बात पर नहीं हंस सकता था, इसलिए वो शीशे को अपना सबसे अच्छा मित्र समझते थे. सो ही स्टार्टेड प्रैक्टिसिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ द मिरर, डिड ऑनलाइन कोर्सेज, ही आल्सो ज्वाइंड सम ऑनलाइन कोर्सेज अबाउट पब्लिक स्पीकिंग. कोच अश्योर्ड मी दैट देयर वॉज नथिंग रॉन्ग विद मी. जो कोच थे उन्होंने उनको अश्योर किया, उनको भरोसा दिलाया दैट there was nothing wrong with me, that it is not Danish fault that he is not able to speak in front of the public. Uski koi galti nahi hai, usme koi kami nahi hai, but I only suffered from what they call stage fright. Coach ne unhe kya bataya, mujhme sirf yahi kami hai ki mujhe stage se dar lagta hai, manch par logon ke samne bolne se mujhe dar lagta hai, baki mujhme kisi cheez ki koi kami nahi hai. He gave me training or for months he taught me the art of public speaking, and for many months he took the training of public speaking and he taught him the art of public speaking means art of public speaking logon ke samne bolne ki kala means how to speak, how can we speak in front of the public confidently and without hesitation and with confidence, कि लोगों के सामने किस तरह से confidence से बिना हिचकिचाहट के आप बोल सकते हैं. इसके लिए कोच ने उन्हें कई महीने तक ट्रेनिंग दी और उन्होंने भी बहुत मेहनत की. Now what happened next? Danish a public speaker. At last the big occasion came. At last the big occasion came means अंत में वो बड़ा महान अवसर आया. Occasion means अवसर. I was to speak. I went to the stage with firm and graceful steps. I introduced the topic to the audience and started. A loud applause confirmed that I spoke really well. I had overcame my hesitation and stage fright forever. Very soon I became an established speaker and orator. So what happened? अंत में इतना प्रैक्टिस करने के बाद, सब कुछ करने के बाद, अंत में दानिश जब स्टेज में बोलने गए तो जो अप्लॉज था, ऑडियंस का जो अप्लॉज था, तालियां थी, जो चीयर्ड किया, हाउ डिड द ऑडियंस चीयर्ड हिम, अप्लॉज हिम, जितनी तालियां बजी थी, दैट कन्फर्म्ड, उसने ये कन्फर्म कर दिया था दैट आई स्पोक वेरी वेल, कि मैंने जो कुछ बोला था बहुत अच्छा बोला था. एंड आई हैड ओवरकम एंड इन दिस वे ही हैड ओवरकेम हिज हेजिटेशन एंड स्टेज फ्राइट. ही वन हिज हेजिटेशन, जो उनका हेजिटेशन था, हिचकिचाहट थी, जो फियर था, जो डर था बोलने का, और जो स्टेज पर जाने का जो फ्राइट था, फियर था, वो उन्होंने जीत चुके थे एंड वेरी सून ही बिकेम एन एस्टेब्लिश्ड स्पीकर एंड ओरेटर, और बहुत जल्दी वो एक प्रख्यात स्पीकर वक्ता बन गए एंड ओरेटर बन गए. सो दैट वॉज अ इंस्पिरेशनल जर्नी, एक प्रेरणादायक एक यात्रा थी दानिश धमानी की, जो आपके सामने शेयर की गई है. नाउ चैट बॉक्स खोलेंगे. नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, हियर आर सम क्वेश्चन रिगार्डिंग हिज स्टोरी, यू हैव टू आंसर दीज क्वेश्चंस. आवाज नहीं आ रहा, बोल रहे हैं क्या? गुड, आवाज आ रहा है क्या? क्लियर बच्चे कैसे बोल रहे. सो नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. हाँ, नरेटर वॉन्ट्स कर दिए ना पहले. नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. ये नाउ प्लीज आंसर, स्टार्ट राइटिंग योर आंसर. योर वेरी सिंपल क्वेश्चन रिगार्डिंग स्टोरी, हु इज दानिश धमानी, प्लीज स्टार्ट राइटिंग. स्टूडेंट्स, यू हैव टू आंसर इन योर चैट बॉक्स, हु इज दानिश धमानी, कौन था, कौन है, एंड व्हाई डिड ही गेट नर्वस. Did he feel the same fear at college? सुन रहे हैं क्या बच्चे लोग? Students, you have to answer all these questions. Who is Danish Dhamani? Start writing in chat box. नहीं आ रहा है क्या? क्या हो रहा है? Poet, student, आवाज ठीक है मैम. Who was he? He was a. What did he do to overcome that fear? How did the instructor teach him? कैसे चेक करेंगे? Please check the answers. Answers. But answer I am not getting the answer. College student. Yes, ma'am. Question नहीं दिख रहा है. Please write your answers. Question is clear, beta. Who is Danish Dhamani? Why did he get nervous? Did he feel the same fear in college? College student. Yes, he was a college student. He completed his engineering. And what did he do to overcome that fear? What did the instructor teach him? Please write your answers. How did he overcome his fear in public speaking? महेश्वरी, आदिति, आदिति वर्मा, साउंड आ रही कि नहीं आ रही है? कि नहीं आ रही है? सो वी केम टू नो दैट दानिश धमानी वॉज अ इंजीनियरिंग स्टूडेंट एंड ही ऑल्सो स्टार्टेड हिज ऐप ओ ऑडियो ऐप दैट वॉज द पब्लिक स्पीकिंग रिलेटेड टू पब्लिक स्पीकिंग. In that app, he started artificial language. He talked about the artificial language. And he had the fear of speaking in front of the public. Yes. But he overcame by practicing. He overcame his public speaking. And he became a famous public speaker, and he also conquered his fear. Now we come to the next slide. Agli slide, chale. Yes, narrator wants to convey a definite message that doing well in anything required a great willpower, determination, hard work, perseverance, and a great deal of struggle. यहाँ पे हमको जो narrator है, जो कहानीकार है दानिश धमानी, हमको एक message देना चाहते हैं कि will power से, डिटर्मिनेशन से एंड हार्ड वर्क से वी कैन गेट ओवर आवर फियर. किसी तरह का भी हम फियर जो है उसको हम जीत सकते हैं. आगे बढ़िए एक स्लाइड में. चलिए अब हो गया, बहुत टाइम हो जाएगा. यस, वी कम टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. थीम टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द related a story, deep water. This is a real life account of experiencing fear and the isko side mein kar sakte hain. Yes, he was nervous. Prachi has answered. Still coming the answer. This lesson, Deep Water, is a real life personal account of experiencing fear and step taken to overcome it. Hydrophobia, aquaphobia. ये जो कहानी आज हम पढ़ने जा रहे हैं ये राइटर का यानी विलियम डगलस का एक अपना लाइफ का एक एक्सपीरियंस है. किस तरह से हाउ डिड ही डेवलप हिज फियर फॉर वाटर एंड हाउ डिड ही व्हाट एफर्ट डिड ही डू टू ओवरकम दैट फियर. जो राइटर है उनको पानी से बचपन में एक डर हो गया था. किस तरह से उन्होंने जीता, उसके जीतने के लिए क्या क्या उन्होंने प्रयत्न किए, उसके बारे में हम पढ़ेंगे. एंड हाइड्रोफोबिया, HYDROPHOBIA, hydrophobia and aquaphobia is means the fear of water. When we have fear of water, excessive fear of water, then it is called hydrophobia and aquaphobia. Now the sub theme is psychological analysis of fear. Why did this fear happens in anyone? किसी ये जो इसका मनोवैज्ञानिक जो fear है वो क्यों होता है उसका विश्लेषण इसमें किया जाएगा. In death there is peace, there is terror only in the fear of death. All we have to fear is fear itself. Will to live is strong than will to die. So we are going to read, this is the sub theme. We will analyze the why did a fear takes place in a person. Now the next slide, learning outcomes of the lesson. Learners will be able to understand text and identify main ideas, characters, sequence of ideas or events and relate with their personal experiences. So we are going to, what learning outcomes mean after reading this chapter, what the students will be able to do. They will learn, they will understand the text, they will identify the main ideas and characters, and they will also share they will identify the story. Respond to a variety of question on familiar and unfamiliar text, and the most important learning outcome of this chapter is understand and respond to the psychological problems like fear, anxiety and stress, and learn to overcome these fears. तो इसमें हम देखेंगे किस तरह से एंग्जाइटी जो चिंता होती है, प्रेशर दबाव होता है, किसी चीज का डर होता है, किस तरह से हम उसको जीत सकते हैं अपने एफर्ट्स के द्वारा. Now here is the summary, what is the lesson is all about. In Deep Water, the author recounts his childhood experience near sea beach in California when he swept away with water. He also recalls a childhood misadventure. He describes how he was tossed into a pool by a big boy. He was nearly drowned in the swimming pool. He was so much frightened and panicked that the fear of water stayed with him. For years he was transformed into a perfect swimmer by an instructor, and finally after a lot of swimming practice he was able to overcome his fear of water. So in this chapter we are going to read that the narrator or the writer, when he was a small boy, he experienced a disaster in the beach of California when he went with his father at the California beach. Suddenly a powerful wave came and tossed him into the and swept over him. And after some time, जब वो कैलिफोर्निया बीच में अपने पिता अपने फादर के साथ गए थे तो जो लहरें थी वो अचानक से बहुत बड़ी लहर आती है और वो उसमें नीचे दब जाते हैं. ही ऑलमोस्ट बरीड अंडर द वेव एंड वेन ही स्वेप्ट अवे विद वॉटर ही गॉट फ्राइटन एंड आफ्टर सम टाइम्स that misadventure, that type of misadventure also happened with him when he was 10 or 12 years old and he was practicing in a swimming pool. A big boy threw him into the swimming pool and that was a very frightening and panicked experience for him. Ek bade se ladke ne unko swimming pool mein dala jiske karan wo pani mein niche dub gaye aur ye bahut zyada frightening and horrifying experience tha unke liye. He was transformed into a perfect, but how? But he developed a great fear for water. पानी को लेकर के उनको बहुत डर लगा, लेकिन बाद में उन्होंने decide किया कि उनको इसको fear को दूर करना है. And he took a training, he practiced a lot, And he transformed into a perfect swimmer by an instructor. He also hired a coach. And finally, after a lot of swimming practice, he was able to overcome his fear of water. बहुत प्रयत्न करने के बाद उन्होंने अपने ये जो उनका फियर था वाटर का वो खत्म हो गया. Now, subtext one, we have subtexted the lesson for you. Narrator's aversion, dislike of water, to water. Now, narrator's aversion, A-V-R-S-I-O-N. Aversion means dislike or fear. किसी चीज के को ना के प्रति भय पैदा हो जाना, hatred पैदा हो जाना, that is called aversion. So, how did the narrator develop his fear for water? किस तरह से उनको पानी के प्रति डर develop हुआ? We are going to read. He's narrating when he was 3 or 4 years old, his father took him to the beach in California. While surfing, right, the waves knocked him down and he swept over him. He was buried in water. His breath was gone. He got frightened. The terror of water froze in his mind. So what happened in the California beach? When he was 3 or 4 years old, his father took him to the beach. He went to the sea beach in California, and suddenly when he was surfing, surfing means riding a wave towards the seashore. As you can see in the picture, this is called surfing. So suddenly a big powerful wave come, बहुत बड़ी सी लहर आती है, शक्तिशाली तरंगे आती हैं समुद्र में और उनको नीचे गिरा देती हैं. And the little boy of 4 years old buried, almost buried, माने दब जाना पूरी तरह से उसके ऊपर. लहरों के नीचे वो दब जाते हैं. His breath was gone. He was unable to breathe. वो सांस लेने में उनको परेशानी होती है. And the little boy got frightened. He got very frightened. वो बहुत ज्यादा डर जाते हैं. And the terror of water froze in his mind. And that terror, terror माने extreme fear, बहुत ज्यादा डर होता है. Terrorist word you must have heard. बहुत ज्यादा डर था जो उनका पानी के प्रति. That froze in his mind, that went deep in his mind. जो पानी को लेके उनका डर था उसके दिमाग में बहुत ज्यादा अंदर तक बैठ जाता है. When he was 10 or 11 years old, they lived near to Yakima River because she thought the river was treacherous. As its depth was not definite and the water level could rise any time. When he was 10 or 11 years old, और जब वो लगभग 11 और 12 वर्ष के थे तो वो they lived near to Yakima River. एक Yakima River है in Washington state. In Yakima city is also there. He started living there and his mother asked him, warned him not to go to Yakima River. उनकी माँ ने उन्हें मना किया था कि Yakima River में आप नहीं जाएंगे because the Yakima River was treacherous. ये बहुत treacherous थी, बहुत dangerous थी. Treacherous means something very dangerous, something very deceptive. बहुत खतरनाक थी, disloyal थी, उसके विश्वास नहीं. We can't trust the river. There were many cases of drowning in the river. जो river थी उसमें डूबने के बहुत ज्यादा cases हुए थे और उसकी जो depth थी, जो गहराई थी वो भी निश्चित नहीं थी. And the water level could rise any time. There were many drowning cases regarding the Yakima River. तो उसकी उनकी माँ उनको वहां जाने से बार बार मना करती थी. He was allowed to learn swimming in YMCA. It was only 3 to 4 feet deep at the starting and maximum 9 feet deep. The depth increased gradually. Now, narrator's mother warned him not to go to Yakima River, but she allowed him to learn swimming in YMCA pool. उनकी माँ ने उन्हें Yakima River जाने से मना किया था, but she allowed him that he can swim in the YMCA pool. YMCA, it is the abbreviation of Young Men Christian Association. This is the name of the club and there was a swimming pool. That is called YMCA swimming pool. It was only 3 to 4 deep at the starting and maximum 9 feet deep. The depth increased gradually. So the YMCA pool was safe for the swimming for the children. And it was only at the starting, it was only 2-3 feet deep and its depth was only 9 feet deep. And the deep jo tha, jo gehrai thi, jo depth tha, that was very gradual. Dheere dheere gehrai badhti thi, ek saath nahi thi. He got a pair of water wings, a hollow ring shaped wing of plastic as soon as he went near the pool. His unpleasant memories of the beach returned back. He got a pair of water wings. For swimming, he got a water wings. Water wings is a hollow ring shaped wing of plastic. As you can see in the picture, a child is wearing this water wings. It helps in swimming. And he also bought a water wings for him. He went near the pool, his unpleasant memories of the beach returned. But as soon as he went near the pool, his unpleasant memories regarding the beach, regarding the water again struck him. जैसे ही वो स्विमिंग पूल के पास जाते थे तो उनकी अनप्लीजेंट मेमोरीज जो है वो आ जाती थी. Now here students, understanding text one for you. You have to answer all these questions chat box. And read this question and answer. And aversion for water means, what is the meaning of aversion for water? Start writing your answer. People fear, and yes, there were so many answers there. What is the right answer? He developed a fear or dislike for water. He started to enjoy in water. He developed liking for water. He started playing in water. What is the right answer? Yes, A. Suniksha, Nikita, so Khushbu answered A. Yes. Aversion. Aversion means a fear or dislike. किसी चीज के प्रति dislike होना, नापसंद करना या डर होना, hatred होना, that is called aversion. Now the answer is A. Naina has answered, Sukhdev has answered, and I can read. Shreyans has answered fear or dislike. Now come to the next question. He developed a fear or dislike. Preeti has also answered. Now the next question, bachcho, do second question ka answer dijiye. Yes, yes, Indu, Ayushi. Now the second question, the Yakima River was treacherous. What is the meaning of treacherous? The river was beautiful. The river was dangerous. The river was harmless. The river was always full of water. What is the meaning of treacherous? The Yakima River was treacherous. Start writing your answers. So please, dekhiye na. आंसर देखिए ना बच्चों का आंसर. याकिमा रिवर वॉज, यस द आंसर इज याकिमा रिवर. सेकेंड क्वेश्चन, यस बी बी कामिनी, तेज कोठारी, योगिता, सोना, यस ऑल ऑफ यू हैव आंसर्ड बी बी फ्रॉम राकेश, रेनू. Yes, Yakima, so many answers are coming. All have answered right. Now the next question. Third question for you. Which incident in Douglas' life made him scared of water? Which incident in Douglas' life made him scared for water? इंसिडेंट नियर याकिमा रिवर, इंसिडेंट एट सी बीच इन कैलिफोर्निया. जो लेखक थे, जो नैरेटर थे, वो कौन से इंसिडेंट से उनको डर, पानी के प्रति भय पैदा हुआ था? इंसिडेंट एट सी बीच इन कैलिफोर्निया. यस शिल्पी हैज आंसर्ड, जयंत एंड सम अदर. आई यस द आंसर इज बी, सी बीच इन कैलिफोर्निया. खुशबू, श्वेता, शिल्पी, दामिनी, तीज, नो आंसर इज बी. नाउ द थर्ड फोर्थ क्वेश्चन. फोर्थ क्वेश्चन, डगलस प्रीफर टू गो टू YMCA पूल टू लर्न स्विमिंग पूल बिकॉज इट वॉज नियर हिज हाउस. द पूल वॉज सेफ. हिज मदर आस्क्ड हिम टू गो देयर. द पूल वॉज फॉर यंग मैन. स्टार्ट राइटिंग द आंसर. Douglas preferred to go to Y. Why did he go to YMCA pool to learn swimming? Which is the answer? Yes, the pool was safe. Damini, Kamini, Shilpi, B, B, answer is B. क्योंकि pool जो था वो safe था. The answer is B. Kumar Sagar, Kumud. Now we come to the next slide. The misadventure at YMCA pool. What is the misadventure? Misadventure means a unpleasant incident, an unfortunate incident, tragedy or disaster. जो कोई एक अप्रिय घटना होती है, दुखद घटना होती है, that is called misadventure. So what happened in YMCA pool में क्या हुआ? The narrator was alone at the pool. He didn't dare to go inside water alone. Then came a big bully of a boy. He was a beautiful physical specimen. He cried, "Hi, skinny." So what happened in YMCA pool? When narrator was all alone in the YMCA pool, he was waiting for other children, and then suddenly a big bully of a boy who was a very built, who had a very muscular physique and who was 18 years old, he came and he threw him into the water, and he called him "Hi, skinny," because he was very lean and thin. So he called him "Hi, skinny, how would you like to duck in the water? How would you like if I throw you into the water?" So ek bada sa ek ladka aaya, usne usse kya kiya, utha karke he tossed him and threw him into the pool. Then he picked the narrator up and tossed him into the deep end. Douglas had no choice. He did not know swimming. He landed in a sitting position, but he did not lose his mind. While going to the bottom, he made a plan. So what happened? All of a sudden, Douglas realized that he is going into the deep. Usne mehsoos kiya ki wo niche ja raha hai, but he didn't know swimming. He landed in a sitting position. When he went into the pool, he landed in a sitting position and he did not lose his mind. He understood that he was going into the pool, but he didn't lose his senses. He was understanding everything what was going with him. Wo jaan raha tha ki uske sath kya ho raha hai. While going to the bottom, he made a plan. And while going into the pool, he made a plan. And what was the plan? His plan was that as soon as he touched the bottom, he decided to make a big jump. He would try to come to the surface. He would lie. Finally, he would paddle to the edge of the pool. So he planned that as soon as he touched the bottom, जैसे ही वो pool का bottom touch करेगा, he would make a big jump and he would come to the surface of the pool. He would lie flat on the then when he came into the on the surface of the pool, he would lie on the water. Finally, he would paddle to the edge of the pool. जैसे ही वो नीचे जाएगा, वो अपने पैरों से उसके सतह को छुएगा और एक बड़ा सा जंप लेगा, and then he finally would come to the surface of the pool. तो उसके किनारे वो आ जाएगा. That was his plan. Now we come to the next slide. He grew panicky. Those 9 feet were more like 90. His lungs were ready to burst. Now what happened? He planned that he will do, but it didn't work according to him, because those 9 feet were more like 90. His lungs were ready to burst. Uske jo lungs the, he was unable to breathe, or because he gulped most of the water. So he was unable to breathe properly. And that 9 feet deep pool seemed to him 19 feet deep. वो जो 9 feet लंबा गहरा जो pool था, उनको 90 feet गहरा महसूस होने लगा, because he was drowning, क्योंकि वो डूब रहे थे. But when he hit the bottom, he gathered all his strength and he made a great spring upward. He came up rather slowly, but he tried his best. He opened his eyes but saw nothing but water. वो ऊपर तक वो आ गए थे, But what did he see? He see nothing but water. Except water, he was not able to see anything. He grew panicky. He was worried. He was terrified. He was confused what to do. He was suffocating. He tried to cry, but no sound came out. He swallowed water and choked. His legs were paralyzed and rigid. So what happened? His plan was failed because he was drawn and he was suffocating. Suffocating means he was not breathing properly because there were he gulped a lot of water. Bahut sara pani unke andar chala gaya tha. He swallowed water and choked. He was unable to breathe. His legs were paralyzed. Paralyzed means he was unable to move his legs. That got rigid and stiff. When he was not able to move his body or his legs or doing anything properly. सब कुछ जैसे रिजिड हो गया था, सख्त हो गया था, स्टिफ हो गया था, and he was not in a position to do anything. Now he is stuck underwater. A great force pulled him underwater. He was getting dizzy, went down and dizzy. He tried his best, but he was not succeeded in his attempt, and he was pulled. Great force of water pulled him underwater. जो पानी का जो तेज बहाव था उसने उसको पानी में नीचे खींच लिया, and that made him dizzy. Dizzy means feeling giddy, unconscious. He became unconscious. उनको चक्कर आने लगा, and then stark terror seized him. Then a stark. Stark means very sharp, severe. Terror means fear, and he was struck in a very severe fear. His arms would not move. He tried to call for help. Nothing happened. He tried all the efforts what he could do in that pool, but nothing happened. लेकिन कुछ भी उन्होंने पूरी मदद लेने की पूरी कोशिश की, लेकिन उनके साथ कुछ भी नहीं हुआ. He sucked for air but got only water. Then all effort ceased. He felt like sleeping. He sucked for air but got he tried to breathe. उन्होंने सांस लेने की कोशिश की, but what did he take inside his body? Only water. Then all effort ceased. जितने उन्होंने प्रयत्न किए थे बचने के, बाहर आने के, सबके सब उनके खत्म हो गए, फेल हो गए. He felt like sleeping and he went in a drowsing position. He crossed the oblivion. When he woke up, he found himself lying on his stomach beside the pool. And he crossed the oblivion. Oblivion means state of being unconscious. He was not in a position to realize or to understand anything. वो बेहोश हो गए. He was unable to think or feel anything. उन्हें कुछ महसूस नहीं हो रहा था. And when he woke up, he found himself lying on his stomach beside the pool. And when he woke up, और जब उनके नींद खुली, तो he found himself that he was lying near the pool on his stomach. उन्होंने पाया कि वो पूल के पास पेट के बल पड़े हुए थे. उन्होंने अपने को महसूस किया. The chap who threw him in said that he was only fooling, but the narrator had nearly died. And the chap means a boy who threw him. जिस लड़के ने उनको फेंका था उसने कहा he was only fooling. वो तो केवल it was only a prank, केवल मजाक कर रहा था. But the narrator had nearly died. But that it was a near death experience for the narrator. And in this way he felt the death like experience. जो एक मृत्यु तुल्य जो कष्ट होता है, जो उसका अनुभव होता है, वो उन्होंने महसूस किया. सेट नेक्स्ट लाइन या हाँ. सो स्टूडेंट्स, देयर इज ऑल्सो एन एक्सरसाइज फॉर यू. सो चैट बॉक्स प्लीज, यू हैव टू मैच दिस मिस एडवेंचर. There is a matching exercise for you. Start matching misadventure, YMCA pool, panicky, William Douglas, Yakima, deep water, tragedy, disaster, river, pool, confused and scared. वन मिस एडवेंचर, मिस एडवेंचर को किससे मैच करेंगे बेटा? कंफ्यूज्ड एंड मिस एडवेंचर, बी यस बी, प्रीति, नैना, अनन्या, चंदू, यस बी, मिस एडवेंचर मीन्स ट्रेजेडी और डिजास्टर। YMCA, YMCA क्या है बेटा? YMCA को मैच करिए टू, YMCA इज अ पूल, डी, यस, निकिता साहू, माहेश्वरी, आई एम अनेबल टू रीड योर नेम्स बेटा, सो मैनी स्टूडेंट्स हैव आंसर्ड करेक्ट, श्रेयांस, डी, या YMCA इज द नेम ऑफ अ पूल। नाउ द थर्ड क्वेश्चन इज पैनकी, पैनकी मीन्स पैनकी, ई, यस, अदिति, प्रिंसेस ई, कंफ्यूज एंड स्केयर्ड, ई ई, खुशबू, योगिता, राकेश, ई। नाउ फोर्थ विलियम डगलस, विलियम डगलस किसको मैच करेंगे? विलियम डगलस, हु इज विलियम डगलस? ए भानु प्रताप, चंद्र कुमार, विलियम डगलस इज द राइटर ऑफ दिस लेसन, डी पॉटर, यस, जयंत, पृथ्वी, नेहा गुप्ता, हेमेश, कामिनी, याकिमा। नाउ द फिफ्थ, फिफ्थ को मैच करिए याकिमा, व्हाट इज याकिमा? याकिमा इज द नेम ऑफ अ, याकिमा, सी, यस, रिवर इज द नेम ऑफ अ रिवर, अयोध्या, जयंत, पृथ्वी, भानु प्रताप, सो मैनी स्टूडेंट आंसर्ड करेक्ट, यस, थैंक यू ऑल ऑफ यू स्टूडेंट्स, यू हैव फॉर योर पार्टिसिपेशन, although I have not pronounced your names, but thanks to all because of the next slide. Yes, here is a homework for you. How did you learn? Please note down your homework. How did you learn to ride bicycle or scooter or motorcycle? Write an essay recounting such an experience, including your fear, encouragement or criticism that you received from others. I think you must have understood the question. आपको आपने साइकिल चलाना, स्कूटर चलाना, मोटरसाइकिल कैसे सीखा, आपको अपना अनुभव शेयर करना है और वो चलाते समय आपको क्या क्या एनकरेजमेंट किए, कैसे आप प्रोत्साहित हुए और कैसे आपको क्रिटिसिज्म आलोचना का सामना करना पड़ा। You have to write your experience. Now the second question, what is the misadventure that William Douglas speak about? कौन सा misadventure, कौन सी unfortunate incident William Douglas के साथ हुआ था? You have to tell about this. And the third question is, how did this experience affect him? और वो कैसे इस fear से प्रभावित हुए थे? So that was the first part of the deep water. We have learned how did the narrator develop his fear for water and what did what was the experience of when he was going into the water? कैसे उन्होंने पानी के प्रति उनका भय पैदा हुआ और जब वो डूब रहे थे उन्होंने क्या अनुभव किया? In the next part we will learn how he overcome that fear. उन्होंने अपने इस डर को कैसे भगाया, इसके बारे में हम अगले उसमें पढ़ेंगे, next part. Thanks to all.
Thank you very much, Vijayta ma'am. With the help of chat box, you made the session very interactive. That's a great job, really. You did. I must appreciate. I thank our all students who participated, who joined our online classes. And this is the time when we have to say goodbye. Namaste.